Well, Malacañang's chief legal counsel, Juan Ponce Enrile, not in favor of reviving the office of the presidential chief of staff. Vic Rodriguez was appointed chief of staff after he resigned as executive secretary on Saturday. But in a memorandum sent to President Marcos, Enrile argued that it was an unnecessary and redundant post. He is also against the draft special order that would have given more powers to Rodriguez, including signing privileges and the power to implement policies. The approved draft relegates the new office as the coordination mechanism of the office of the president, as described by the palace press secretary. Among Rodriguez's new functions include being the presidential strategist, policy advisor, and presidential advocate. The office of the presidential chief of staff was abolished by former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo in 2008. Its previous functions include holding the schedule of the president in coordination with the cabinet officer for presidential engagements and supervising the president's activities and engagements.
Votes in favor of splitting Maguindanao into two provinces win by a landslide. Anjo Bagawisan tells us more about the results of Saturday's historic plebiscite in this report.
Applause greeted the arrival of two ballot boxes at the Provincial Canvassing Center in Buluan, Maguindanao, Sunday afternoon. These contain the certificates of canvass of votes from the towns of Upi and South Upi, both 4 hours away on the other end of the province. At last, provincial canvassers could wrap up their 5-hour count of results from 36 municipalities in Saturday's historic plebiscite. The result was expected.
On the basis of the foregoing, we hereby proclaim to ratify the division of the province of Maguindanao into two provinces. May Allah bless us all.
Yes votes to splitting the province won by a landslide with 99% of those cast. Over 5,000 votes, meanwhile, voted no, less than 1%. In 8 towns, not a single vote for no. All of them will soon be part of Maguindanao del Sur. Meanwhile, a solitary no vote in Dato Udin Sinsuat town, the prospective capital of Maguindanao del Norte. The law ratified by the plebiscite will create Maguindanao del Norte from 12 towns. 24 towns in the southeast portion of Maguindanao will form Maguindanao del Sur. The win greeted with optimism by some Maguindanao residents.
Manali yung east, yes. Tapos maganda talaga kung makatulong niya sa mga tao.
Kung pananong east, siguro kung yun ang nakakabuti. Kasi hati na yun, pero para sa akin okay na yun kasi panalo na yun.
Mas matutukan po yung pamahalaan natin.
Baka makatulong sa aming mga tao na mga maliliit.
In a province regularly plagued by threats of election violence, this plebiscite was a breath of fresh air for Maguindanao, which experienced none during the voting day. And along with it, one of the highest voter turnout for a plebiscite in the Philippines.
The local poll body, hopeful future polls in Maguindanao could be just as peaceful.
I am very confident that that can be replicated as long as the preparation is also replicated. For this event, we prepared as early as July.
Nearly 87% of the province's more than 818,000 voters cast their ballots on Saturday, ranking the plebiscite second in terms of turnout next to the 1998 referendum creating Compostela Valley Province that had nearly 90%. The national poll body adds the Maguindanao plebiscite now has the most votes cast for a plebiscite with over 700,000.
This is just a start of something new for the province. Patunayan niyo po na ang mga mamamayan ng Maguindanao ay hindi nagkamali sa pagboto nila ng resounding yes sa hatian para sa dalawang probinsya.
Poll body watchdog National Citizens Movement for Free Elections, or NAMFREL, sees a major factor behind the high showing of voters.
Alam naman natin dito, no, yung mga political families exercise a lot of influence sa constituents nila. Sa tingin natin is parang yung mga patronage and ano, patriarchal societies, di ba? So parang dependent din yung mga constituents sa kanila. So and we have that ano, alam niyo naman yung we have that sense of utang na loob. So pag natulungan yung nangangailangan, may utang na loob yan, automatic. So that, again, that could have played a large role.
For now, Maguindanao's major political clans are also celebrating the win. Governor Bai Mariam Mangundadatu will lead Maguindanao del Sur, while Vice Governor Bai Aini Sinsuat will rise as Governor of Maguindanao del Norte.
Magtulungan ang probinsya, magtulungan ang rehiyon. Wala pong imposible, hindi natin maiangat ang buong lalawigan, ang buong rehiyon ng Bangsamoro.
May stigma ang Maguindanao as a whole. So i-uplift ho natin yon at babaguhin natin into a better Maguindanao.
Other elective officials will be appointed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Governor Mangundadatu adds, both provinces may not yet be up and running by this year. A 60-day transition period will soon begin for the upcoming provincial governments to create and fill posts in their agencies and pass budgets for 2023. Andrew Bagawisan, ABS-CBN News, Maguindanao.